Thank you so much for tuning in today. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button down below. It really goes a long way to help out the channel. So with all this gear right here, you could totally get into moto camping for under $350. You know, when I get to camp, all I really want is a nice place to sleep. I want to be comfortable, have somewhere to chill in my chair, and have a nice hot meal. This is everything you need to get started in moto camping. I want to go through all these items with you one by one and tell you why I picked each one out. A lot of them have come highly recommended from other YouTubers. These have had great reviews. Sleeping pad from Dan Becker and Kyle from Backcountry ADV Moto. And this sleeping bag here from Tim Collins on 40 Times Around. They have great detailed reviews on these products here, and I would totally recommend checking them out. But let's go through everything we have here now. All right, let's take a look. We got the chair, a little cook set, pint cup, bowl. Here's the inside of the tent. Super roomy in here. We can get all our stuff in here. It's got little stash pockets. It's got a little, it comes with a little loft up on top. You can hang it up. Here's our climate sleep pad. And you can see that the sleeping bag lofts up really nice. Here's our pillow, and you could strap that around if you want so you won't lose it, and it has a removable sheet. Take that off later. There we go. There's the climate bag insulated. So let's talk about the sleeping bag. This is the Teton Trailhead 20 degree bag. It's a mummy style, but it's not actually a mummy. It's a little bit wider. And the material on the inside is taffeta, and the fill is synthetic as well. There's a stash pocket for your keys, wallet. I like to keep my phone in here at night because it keeps it warm and it doesn't drain the battery as fast. It does have these baffles right here along the zipper on the inside. Keeps the cool air from coming in. It does have the hood. If you don't want to have the pillow in there, you have the hood, and you can put the pillow on the pad. It just depends on how hot out it is or cold. And it does have a cinch cord right here, so you can tighten up the hood on your head. It's pretty cool. This thing's long, and it's a lot wider than I thought it was going to be for a mummy. So I guess it's going to be great for side sleepers, stomach sleepers, and just about anybody. All right, now next we have the Hike Venture inflatable pillow. And it comes with a strap. You can hook it onto your sleeping pad so you don't lose it. I don't know if, about you guys, but I've had pillows where they just slide off, and by the middle of your sleep in the night, you're so frustrated because you can't find your pillow. It's just sliding around everywhere. But this thing has a removable sheet. You can see right here. You could take it off and wash it. And this is quilted. This is super soft, super nice. I like how it, I just like the shape of it, how it has this little contour right here. I have to have a pillow. No matter what, when I'm camping, I want to be comfortable. And this pillow hits the mark. Inflator right here. This thing blows up in about 3 breaths. It has a strap. It is removable, so you could unsnap it there when you wash it, or if you don't want the strap, it's right there. All right, let's talk about this tent. It's a four-season, lightweight, freestanding tent, and it's double-walled, which is ideal for camping when it's cold out. Basically, it lets the condensation go to the second wall and drip down the sides on the outside instead of dripping in the inside all over your tent and making you wet and cold. The footprint is 84.5 by 51 inches, and it has 2 vestibules, and there's lots of tie down points. It comes with a paracord already on there, which helps in super windy conditions. This thing goes together super nice. There's a ring that all the poles go into, and it sets up like a spider, so when you're setting it up, it's not flopping around. When you put it in the holes down there, everything stays nice. You can see down there, it's got the nice little loop. And these are 70, 71 aluminum aircraft. They're 13-inch poles. They're super short. My other poles were about 15 inches on my other tent, and these are a lot smaller, so this will even pack tighter. All right, let's talk about one of my favorite items here is this Fire Maple Fixed R1. This is a 1-liter complete cook system. And what I really like about it is it comes with this neoprene sleeve so you don't burn your hands. nice grab handles that are solid, which keeps everything in there. Like when this bounces around, it won't pop the lid off. And it has a heat exchanger on the bottom with these little rings, which what it does is it makes your fuel last longer by being more efficient. If you've ever used a torch, it takes about 4 to 5 minutes to boil water, where this will take 2 minutes. So if you do the math, you're gonna get twice as many boils out of a bottle. So let's take a look at what comes inside. So it doesn't come with this. I just put this in here to show you, you can make a complete system. And what's cool is they make this little dot here, so when you do put this in there, there's just enough room. So there's your fuel, there's your lid, there's your cup, and there's your torch with the piezo ignition. Super easy fuel valve right here. And this thing, I've already tried it a few times and it's super adjustable. It doesn't burn things. Like, I like the regulator on here is really sensitive. I like it a lot. One thing cool about this is the way the system locks. It has a notch and a dimple. So you slide that in there and it's locked. Boom. Threads on nice, goes. There we go. Super user friendly. I love this thing. What was surprising to me is it came with this bowl, which this thing seems really strong. Eat oatmeal out of it or whatever. Use it as a cup if you forget your cup. But yeah, that's a bonus. So I like that a lot. And the reason why I chose this as part of the setup is I've been using a Fire Maple for about 3 years now, and it's been on a lot of moto camping trips. And I gotta say, this thing is solid. It's been through crashes on my motorcycle. Nothing happened to it. I'm surprised with the 450-pound motorcycle landing on it. Nothing bent, nothing. It just worked perfect. I totally recommend this thing. So I have a jet boil, but I hardly ever use it. When I bought my Fire Maple, I thought I was just gonna get a cheap one that I could take on trips and not worry about breaking, you know, because it was so cheap. But I ended up, it's my go-to. I ended up selling my jet boil on OfferUp and I kept my Fire Maple. They're so durable. They work so good. They boil so fast. They're efficient. It's just a great product. I highly recommend this one. All right, let's go on to the collapsible gear. We'll start out with the bowl. So I don't know about you guys, but I don't like eating Mountain House meals out of a bag. So what I'll do is I'll put it in here. Hot water, Mountain House, seal it up, let it do its thing. It actually stays warmer longer in this than it does in the bag. And then when you're eating your food, you're somewhat civilized. You know, you can get in there and you're not sticking your hand in a bag and getting it all gross. This is just the way to go. And it doesn't take up any space. It's just, it's a no-brainer. I really like this a lot. I've been using one for a while. I didn't really know about it until, you know, you're camping with some guys that have been doing it a long time and you see what they're doing. I'm like, why didn't I think of that? Well, they already did for me. So this is a great setup for the price. And then the next thing is this collapsible pint cup. This thing is sweet. It has a stainless steel, like a thermal little lip around here, so you don't burn your lip if you're drinking hot coffee or hot cocoa, tea, whatever beverage you like. I really like this thing, and it's super sturdy. So I like it. When you set it down, it's not going to collapse. It's super strong. I don't know. I just think it's a no-brainer. It's a great option to bring instead of a GSI cup that takes up a lot of room, where you could nest this in here super easy. That wasn't too easy. You can nest that in there like that, boom. And there's plenty of room to put other stuff in here. You could put your sponge, an extra lighter, a cleaning towel. I mean, there's room in here to put other stuff. So I really like this thing a lot. And for the price, I think it combined, it's like 17 bucks or something. It's a great deal. And last but not least is our titanium Spork. Even though I don't eat my Mountain House meals out of a bag, I still like the long Spork because it comes in handy when you're cooking in here. So I really like that a lot. And it gives you a nice area to hold on to if you're using it as a knife or digging into some, I don't know, whatever. This is just a great tool to have in your arsenal. It doesn't take up any room either. Super light, Comes with a nice little bag. There we go. That's the kit. All right, next we have this chair here. It's called the Ali. I don't even know how to pronounce this thing. We'll say Alio BC. And this is a great chair. It'll hold up to 280 pounds. It comes with extra feet, which I've never seen a chair come with extra feet. And if you don't want to use those feet, it comes with these other feet right here. And these are great for when you're in soft sand or, you know, any kind of mushy terrain. This thing will hold you up. It's such a great little footprint down there. They pop off easy. You put on the other feet, whatever you want to use. Comes with a little stash pocket here. Like if you're dorking the road, you could put your cigars in here, your flask, or I'd put my cell phone in here probably. But yeah, it's a nice chair. It's a good bang for the buck. And it easily just packs away in your stuff. Last but not least is this table right here. This packs down into such a small footprint and it fits right in your back. It's really light, it sets up in 2 seconds. And I mean, look at all the stuff I have on here. I have room for more. I could throw my phone here, a beer, a cigar, but it's good to have a table just because you're not eating on the ground or you're not preparing your food on the ground. You know, it's at a good level with the chair. This is a good thing to have unless you're super ultra lightweight camping and you really don't think you need a table, but when you get there, you're gonna wish you had it. I love bringing the table. I will always bring a table. There we go. Everything I have here will easily pack into a 30 liter dry duffel bag. Everything you see here, and you'll have room to spare. All right, adventure buddies. Thank you for watching all the way to the end. As a bonus, I'm gonna be giving away that cook system that I reviewed. Please leave the name of the cook system in the comments down below. You have to be a subscriber to win. Stay safe on the trail. Thanks for watching. Peace.